Hi everybody, my name is Michael Campbell and I'm here at the 2017 Canadian Science Policy Conference, and I'm here with Greg Dick, the Educational Outreach Director at the Perimeter Institute. Nice to meet you. Thanks for
nice
being with me.
Nice to meet you as well. A pleasure.
Nice to meet you. Thanks. So tell us a little about the Perimeter Institute and what you guys do and why it's important.
Perimeter is a theoretical physics institute. So it was created by Mike Lazaridis almost 20 years ago now to tackle the hardest questions in the universe. Truly to ask the questions about the very fundamental nature of quantum mechanics through to how the universe formed. So that theoretical framework get the best minds around the planet to come together to tackle those questions. That's the number one mandate of the institute. But an equally important mandate is outreach and training. And that was made important from the beginning as well. So, and that's where my role and our, my team, the outreach team, that's where we take our lead from. And there, what we're trying to do, we're trying to take the wonders and the powers of joy of science and bottle it in ways that we can inspire families, we can inspire youth, we can inspire teachers to raise scientific literacy across the country and beyond.
And what are some ways that you guys do that?
So our outreach programming is getting more and more sophisticated. On the public outreach front, we have a public speaking series, which is webcast literally around the globe. And we have some really key partners from Scientific American and Cosmos Magazine in Australia, the BBC, ways that we partner, and that way it just expands the reach and the audience's ability to interact. And we're fortunate enough to be able to get just some really amazing speakers that can captivate the audience with the way they tell a story, captivate the audience with the content of the story. They're talking about how the universe was created, or the very quantum nature, that we're taking advantage of the quantum nature of our world to build computers. So that public speaking series has been incredibly popular over time. What we've leveraged that into is science festivals. We actually host full-blown science festivals, and we did that first locally in Waterloo. That's where Perimeter is. And now recently this year, we took what we've learned in the past about science festivals, and we've taken that across the country as part of Innovation 150 and held festivals in different provinces and cities across the country.
That's really cool.
It's been an amazing way to see Canada and to gauge Canadians. And then the other part of our outreach is students and teachers. And what we're trying to do, well, I'll give you the punchline first. We create resources that help empower teachers to create opportunities for their students to bring science to life. Our resources were used last year alone 10 million times in over 60 countries.
Wow.
It's incredible. It's humbling, but it's also on the backs of teachers. When you give them good products, good activities to engage their kids in a really authentic way, they just use it and share it and share it and share it and share it. And that's how that our reach has really started to hockey stick since we've started that. I would say that the reach, it's grown to that really in the past 5 years from very humble beginnings. But the way we do that, the strategy behind that, it is we do target teachers because we know where teachers are. We know there's a thirst for them to engage their kids, and we want to be able to provide them with we have access to the top cutting edge research, and we have access to unbelievable teachers. We stick those folks together, we come up with these wonderful resources that we then share. So it's a train the trainer model. We create resources, we train a bunch of teachers, they train a bunch of teachers, they train, and it's really worked, and we're excited to see it. Where it's going to go from here.
And these teachers, what age range are they teaching?
So our resources are now from grades 5 through to grade 12. And it started in physics, and we focused on physics, but now it really is about science literacy, and it's about 21st century skills. It's about providing opportunities for kids to identify that if they want to be creative, they want to be critical thinkers and problem solvers, and then we provide opportunities for them to exercise those skills and improve those skills. And that sort of sweeps across disciplines. And science is just one great way to exercise and improve all of those aspects of your person. And this year, specifically with a real bent towards innovation, tied to our Innovation 150 activities across the country, we've made resources that let kids really think deeply about how actually they are already innovators. In small ways, you solve problems all the time with unique and interesting solutions. So we've just wrapped around that a process where they can identify that success, identify what skills it takes to be successful that way, and then practice that.
I wish that was around when I was a kid.
You know, there is such amazing work going on in schools across this country. We're in a really privileged spot. We get to see education systems around the planet. Like I said, 60 countries is where our resources are being used. We're very fortunate in Canada. There are just amazing teachers doing amazing things for kids everywhere. And it's those pockets of excellence that I think we're trying to be conveners of, bring them together, shine a spotlight on them so that more people can see what can be done and then gravitate to that and watch it magnify so that more and more kids say, yeah, I did something like that.
Going back to your Innovation 150, you guys hosted one of the earlier panels here.
Yes.
What was the inspiration behind it and what do you think you accomplished from that panel?
So Innovation 150 was a C150 signature initiative supported by Department of Heritage and some key sponsors. And it's a collaboration between five key partners. So there's Actua, there's the Institute for Quantum Computing at the University of Waterloo, there is CASC, that's the Canadian Association of Science Centers, Ingenium here in Ottawa, the three museums that used to be the Canadian Science and Tech Museums Corporation, and of course Perimeter Institute. So we came together under the C150 signature initiative, Innovation 150, probably almost 2 years ago now, to develop programming, face-to-face programming, online and digital programming, and then share that with Canadians. The panel today was designed to say, this is what we've learned how to do. This is the experiences we had. This is the challenges we ran into. And this is the success that we were able to achieve because we worked together. And just share those transferable skills, the transferable knowledge that this whole experience has given us. And it was great. The participants were fantastic. They asked good questions. They drilled right into some of the key areas. And you know what? We're happy to share, for sure.
That's great to hear. So theoretical physics, it can be a bit of an intimidating topic. So how can you relate and shape it in a way that you can use it to influence politicians and civil servants and stuff?
Theoretical physics, if you want to dampen a cocktail party, just tell them you're in physics. I hated physics in high school and they walk away. At least I blame it on that. You know what? The simple answer is, everything you have around you today, all of the technology, all of the innovative tech that you have and see and use, it all was what the seed was theoretical physics. The theoretical physics of today will be the technology of tomorrow, for sure. So, an example. 100 years ago, there was a scientist, a mathematician, he was thinking about electricity and magnetism. At the time, they were two totally different ideas. And he realized that, you know, electricity and magnetism, they're actually the same phenomena, just two different sides of that same phenomena. He stitched them together in four beautiful little equations. They're called Maxwell's equations. And then there was an experimental physicist who looked at that and said, all right, let's see if that's really true. His name was Hertz. He was in Germany. So he built a spark generator. And if you picture this in his class, he's got a university first year class. He's got this kid turning a crank. And every time he's turning the crank, there's a little spark, little spark, little spark. On the other side of the classroom, all the other kids are there, and there's this big wire loop with just a little cut in it, so the ends are not touching, they're just close. Every time there was a spark on the generator, there was a spark between the ends of these two big wires.
Wow.
The students are like, professor, professor, this is unbelievable, energy is going through empty space. What's next, what's next? And Hertz, apparently, so the story goes, shrugs his shoulders and says, I don't know, nothing, I guess. When in fact, everything electrical, everything digital, our information age, our technological world can be traced directly back to that unification of electricity and magnetism. So the questions that scientists are working at and struggling with at Perimeter will fundamentally change society in 50 and 100 years out, guaranteed.
What are some opportunities for Canada and for Canadians in this field?
Canada punches well above its weight. On if you look at innovation in the past and historically, we punch above our weight. Scientifically, we're a small country and we play in all the biggest fields. We are huge players at CERN. We're huge players around the globe. And specifically in the quantum space, Canada, and even more focused if you look at Ontario and the activities happening in the Waterloo Corridor, from Toronto to Waterloo, the expertise that we're developing in the quantum space, we're world leading right now. And that is absolutely the next revolution. When we go from our current classical computers to quantum computers that truly take advantage of the quantum nature of our world, it'll be a step change that is bigger than from no computers to computers. So right now, Canada is leading. We're in that upper echelon, but now is when you have to double down. You have to put money and resources, energy and talent behind that to take advantage of that lead. And when those first discoveries and those commercializable inventions bubble up, and they're starting, there's a few of them, that we can not only celebrate our success in getting that far, but we can commercialize it. We can make it change the world the way the smartphone has changed the world.
And for the young people that might be watching this, other than getting involved in the Perimeter Institute, what are other ways they can get into this?
If I've learned anything as I've traveled across this country with Innovation 150, there's just a plethora, it's a horrible word to use, but it actually fits, because it's unbelievable amount of opportunities for kids in Canada. Science centers, there are science centers across our country that are keen to engage, and they're interactive, they're cutting edge, they work hard to really provide opportunities for students. There are outreach organizations that are looking for people to help them spread the word. There's a thirst for science across this country. So if you're interested and passionate about science, about math, about engineering, tech, about coding, there are unbelievable amount of opportunities from coast to coast to coast. Look for them, find them, and then just engage, just start. You don't need to have a degree in physics. You don't need to be an expert. You just need to be passionate and care, and you'll find opportunities to engage for sure.
You heard it here. So what drew you guys to this conference?
So CSPC is a fantastic place to engage. You can't work as an island, and the beauty of Canada is that we don't work as an island. Policymakers are engaged with the scientists, are engaged with the educators, are engaged with the communities and the general public. This is a wonderful conference that brings those stakeholders together to talk about how we can chart a path forward, and we definitely want to be part of that conversation, and this is just a wonderful opportunity to do that.
Well, we're very thankful that you're here. Thank you for speaking with me today. Why don't you tell the folks at home how they can get in touch with you and find about the Perimeter Institute?
Absolutely. Thank you very much. So our website is www.perimeterinstitute.ca. We have just an unbelievable amount of resources there for the general public, for students, for teachers. Go, enjoy, dive in, take a look. And if you have any specific questions, my email's on there too. Shoot me a note and I'll connect you with the real geniuses.
Thanks, Greg.
Thank you. Pleasure.
Cheers.